Good evening. I'm Dennis Walcott, President and CEO of the Queens Public Library. I want to extend a warm welcome to you as we celebrate the library's 125th anniversary. On behalf of our board of directors, our staff, our board of trustees, I want to say thank you for all joining us this evening. I'm speaking to you via live stream from our spectacular Elmhurst branch at the intersection of Broadway and 51st Avenue in Northeast Queens. It is a pleasure beyond words to be here and to share this special occasion with you. As we all know, this has been no ordinary year. In fact, it's been an incredibly difficult year, especially for many of our communities in Queens. The coronavirus has taken our loved ones, our family members, our friends, our colleagues, our neighbors, and many of whom lived and worked in this neighborhood, which was once the epicenter of the pandemic in the United States. We keep them in our hearts, along with all the frontline workers, the healthcare heroes, the first responders, the grocery store clerks, and others as we begin to emerge from this worst global health crisis of our lifetimes. I want to also say a special thanks to our neighbors roughly 8 blocks away, Elmhurst Hospital. Elmhurst Hospital, along with our hospitals and other healthcare facilities throughout the borough of Queens and throughout New York, as well as throughout the United States, you deserve a special thanks for all that you have done for all of us. The people of Queens are resilient and strong. We have endured so much together over the past 15 months together. We will rebuild our city and build a more equitable city for all, which is why tonight we celebrate not just the library, its rich past and promising future, but also the people of this great borough of Queens. Throughout the pandemic, the Queens Public Library has been here for our communities. When we were forced to close our physical locations, our creative and dedicated staff quickly pivoted to providing virtual services and expanding our digital collections. We moved our programs online, such as Storytime, job readiness workshops, book clubs, English classes, homework help, author talks, musical performances, college prep sessions, health workshops, and many others. We partnered with the city to turn several of our branches into COVID-19 rapid testing sites and vaccination sites. Despite so many challenges, we remained focused on providing free access to information, learning, opportunity for all, no matter the circumstances. To all of our individuals, our foundations, our businesses, to the board members who have so generously supported the Queens Public Library during this difficult period, during the pandemic, thank you for your steadfast belief in us. Tonight, as the library customers, celebrities, and elected officials speak about why Queens Public Library is so important to them and to all of us, please consider making a donation. Your gift will help us continue to meet our mission and to ensure that the library will thrive for another 125 years. Before we move on, I want to thank all of our sponsors who have been incredibly generous in their support for tonight's event. And I hope you will stay tuned to watch our virtual journal recognizing them at the end of the program. I want to give a very special thanks to Bloomberg Philanthropies, the Margaret and Daniel Loeb Foundation, and the Wolkoff family, Five Points LIC, for making this celebration possible. Now, since it's our 125th birthday, I thought some reminiscing would be in order. So let's take a walk together down History Lane.
Thank you. Wow. I hope you enjoyed that wonderful video. It's remarkable to think about how far the library has come in the past 125 years, how it has always responded to the needs of a rapidly changing borough, and how it has remained a constant in the civic and educational infrastructure of Queens. I'm Carl Kerner, president of the Queens Public Library Foundation Board of Directors and a member of the library's Board of Trustees. It has been a privilege and a true joy to be part of one of the city's most vital and trusted institutions, which serves millions and millions of people as they work to secure the promise of their lives, whatever their identity, background, or circumstance, through the good times and the hard times as well. As a lifelong lover of books and ideas who was born and raised in Queens, I'm proud to be here tonight, and I'm grateful you are here tonight to help us shape our next 125 years. To all of you who have helped support the library, whether as an employee, volunteer, customer, donor, a lifelong resident such as me, or someone new to our community, thank you for making the library's work possible. Throughout the evening, if you're inspired by what you hear and see, please take a few seconds to hold your mobile phone in front of a QR code that will appear in the lower right corner of your screen. It will take you to a website where you can make a donation in support of the library's mission. Our program tonight features the stories of several champions and beneficiaries of Queens Public Library, starting with Awkwafina, a former resident of Forest Hills, whom many of you know from her brilliant roles in Crazy Rich Asians, The Farewell, and Awkwafina is Nora from Queens. She will be followed by a longtime advocate of QPL's work, Queensborough President Donovan Richards. After that, New York Times best-selling author and former Elmhurst resident Min Jin Lee, then Speaker of the New York City Council Corey Johnson, will share what Queens Public Library means to them. We will then hear from several QPL customers who will share with us the library's impact on their lives. Awkwafina, the screen is yours.
Hey, Queens Public Library, it's Awkwafina, and I wanted to wish you a happy 125th birthday. I hope you enjoy the rest of your 120s, because when you get to the 130s, you know, there's more responsibility, you know, you might have a mortgage. So enjoy it while it lasts, drink some White Claws, don't do that. Are children watching this? Are children gonna watch this? You can cut it at some point. For me, growing up in Queens, I think kind of in the most literal and also the most figurative sense, it really taught me about the world. I not only have had at friends' houses at a young age all kinds of different cuisines from all kinds of different countries, but an understanding of also how diverse our country truly is. And it was an experience, I think, that definitely humbles you, and an experience that I think inevitably you're really proud of. I'm very proud of being from Queens. The library is a place where, in a world that constantly wants to divide us, is welcome to everyone. And I think right now, at a time where we need essential resources, the ability to look for jobs, the ability to learn a new language, access to information and technology for everyone is very important. And that's why I will always support the Queens Public Library and everything it does for our community.
Hello, I'm Queensborough President Donovan Richards. On behalf of the nearly 2.4 million residents of Queens, the world's borough, I extend hearty congratulations to the Queens Public Library as it celebrates its 125th anniversary during tonight's QPL virtual gala. Ever since it was established in 1896, the Queens Public Library has had a mission to cultivate the personal and intellectual growth of Queens residents by offering high-quality services and resources that meet our literacy and learning needs. Year in and year out, the Queens Public Library has excelled in fulfilling this mission, and has done so despite the many challenges our borough has faced, including the current COVID-19 pandemic. QPL offers lifelong learning opportunities through a diverse collection of books and other materials that meet the informational educational, cultural, and recreational needs and interests of our borough's diverse and changing population. It also welcomes and serves everyone and adheres to the values of integrity, respect, and intellectual freedom as it strives to provide excellent service to all its customers. I therefore congratulate the dedicated and hardworking professionals who provide high-level service to all of those who visit the Queens Public Library's 65 locations. It is thanks to you that Queens Public Library is one of our borough's most treasured institutions and a jewel in our cultural landscape. I hope everyone in attendance enjoys tonight's virtual gala, and I once again congratulate Queens Public Library as we celebrate its 125 years of service.
I think the Queens Public Library was a space in which I felt safe and curious, and I think above all, a sense of normalcy. So if you think about immigration as being something that's incredibly disruptive to anybody's life, and especially when you are a child immigrant, it's not like you chose to go to a new country. So I was immediately handicapped because I didn't speak English. And then I also had personal issues in which I'm incredibly introverted. And it took me an incredibly long time for me to learn how to talk to other kids and to adults and to make my ideas clear in a spoken way. So what happened was that at the library, I was able to read as much as I possibly could. And in those books, I think I was able to understand social interactions. So very often people talk about books being a place that's transporting, but for me, it was really more transformative. But it's almost like being taken to the candy store. So I was able to go and get as many books as I liked. I got this card only because I was just a person who lived in America and it was all free. And mind you, we had very little money when we came to America. So the idea that I could go somewhere, a safe place, a beautiful place, as far as I was concerned, and borrow as many books as I liked, even though I didn't actually know how to read them, it was such a thrilling thing. And for the rest of my life, I feel so strongly connected to libraries. So whether it's in my school or whether it's in a public library or just libraries in general, I mean, one of the greatest things that America has is this idea of a free public library. The last time I was at the Queens Public Library, I saw shelves filled with different language books. And that was really so amazing because it makes a space really welcoming to those who are new to this country. And it had books as well as comic books and videos in different languages. And I thought, that's incredible. It's incredible that America actually allows this much knowledge, media, and communication to be shared by everybody. And to me, Queens is this very magical place that allows diversity, multiplicity, plurality, and inclusiveness. So I really hope that in our future, in our 126th year, that we can even be more welcoming, that we can have even more resources for those who are here. Happy birthday, Library. I love you.
Hello, Queens Public Library. I'm New York City Council Speaker Corey Johnson, here to congratulate you on your 125th anniversary. I hope to look half as good as you when I get to 125. And I want to congratulate tonight's honorees, Nora from Queens herself, Awkwafina, Hari, Kondabolu, Daymond John, and Min Jin Lee. I also want to take an opportunity to thank you all for your incredible work, both during this past year and beyond. Our public libraries are such a treasure for all New Yorkers, but especially those who depend on them for technological access, community, or just a cool place to sit and read. So thank you. And a special thank you to your amazing president and CEO, Dennis Walcott. He is a mensch, who stars in one of my favorite photographs of all time, in which Dennis is fanning himself and my dear friend, Danny Drum, with his exquisite fan during our drag queen story hour. I also want to thank all the librarians and operational staff who work day in and day out to make sure that our libraries are available for our children, our seniors, and anyone else who needs them. You all do so much for us. and ask so little, but I want you to know that your work is seen and appreciated. So on behalf of the entire New York City Council, thank you so, so much. Have a great night. Happy anniversary. I look forward to getting together in person next year.
My name is Mio Catherine Lee.
My name is Shahin Sultana. I live in Jamaica, Queens. I am from Bangladesh.
Hello, my name is Elena, and I'm 4 years old, and I live in Briarwood.
My name is Bonnie Supercorny, and I've lived in Queens since I've been 4 years old.
I'm originally from the Ivory Coast. I moved here in the United States about 14 years ago.
It's definitely important to have the library in a community, especially like Cambria Heights, because we're always, this community is very active. We love doing stuff for each other.
Definitely the most helpful program that I used from the Queens Public Library was the case manager service. That it helped me a lot to prepare all my job interview, resume, cover letter, and everything about that.
I get a grab and go kit. I read books and I do some singing alongs.
When I moved to the Forest Hills, I got Queens Forest Hills library card. That was about 35 years ago. The library card makes me so happy, relaxed. Library is like my close friend's home.
The Queens Library is really means to me a lot. When I came over here and I got my library card, all the time I used to come with my daughter. I borrow a book and she used the computer.
When I became disabled, I could not carry the books to the library or carry books back from the library. So I called up the library and I asked if they had a program for the disabled and homebound, and they gave me this number, and that was about 14 years ago, if not longer. From January of 2000 until October of 2000, I never left my house. All right? Yet the walls were not climbing in on me because of the involvement, the effect that a male book has had on my life. I had people I spoke to on the phone all the time. I had teleconferencing calls. I had virtual calls. Every day was busy.
So at Queens Cambria Heights Library, there is a teen center in the basement, and I love it. I really do. It's important for the teenagers to have a good place to go during the weekends and during even after school, because sometimes you don't want to go straight home after school, and a lot of times sometimes at home can be a little distracting. I know I have older siblings and they're always doing a lot of stuff.
I needed to learn English. I needed a place to learn English that will cost me little or nothing. So I googled, I scheduled an appointment not knowing that my life would change forever, but for the best. And I also went for the GED program, which is the reason I was able to move forward in life, because if it wasn't for the GED program, I don't think I'll be able to express myself the way I'm expressing myself and be able to write English.
The Queens Public Library is vital in every community.
The Queens Public Library helped me, support me, and are always there to give me an advice.
Happy birthday, Queens Public Library.
Awkwafina!
Happy 125th anniversary to Queens Public Library. Thank you for providing all these services in our community.
Happy birthday, and may you have decades more.
Like generations of Queens residents before them, these amazing individuals have relied on the library to support their personal and intellectual growth and to realize their dreams. And we are so grateful to be here for them. Thank you so much to all of our devoted customers and our guest speakers for sharing your stories. Each of our speakers defines who we are as a library, as a borough, and as a city. each represents the amazing diversity of Queens and the tremendous impact of our library system, one of the busiest in the country with more than 11 million visitors and offering more than 87,000 programs a year. Nearly every Queens resident lives within a mile of one of our 66 locations. I grew up in Southeast Queens and have lived there my entire life, from my early years to raising four children and now being a grandparent of eight children. Queens Public Library has always been there for me and my family. Your support will help ensure we are here for the millions of people who count on us each year, tomorrow, next month, and the next 125 years. We are honored to have a few more special guests this evening. Queens District Attorney and avid reader, Melinda Katz, followed by Harry Kondabolu, the comedian, writer, and podcaster, known for his Netflix special, Warn Your Relatives, and council member and the chair of the Cultural Affairs and Libraries Committee, Jimmy Van Bramer, one of Queens Public Library's biggest proponents and a former Queens Public Library staffer. They will be followed by Daymond John, founder and CEO of FUBU and the star of ABC's Shark Tank, and our great, great chair, Michael Rodriguez, chair of our library's Board of Trustees. Melinda, please take us away.
Congratulations to the Queens Public Library on 125 years of service to the people of Queens County. This library has educated generations of children. They have made it a safe environment for children to go after school and learn their lessons or do their homework. Seniors are better off because they can go to the Queens Public Library and read newspapers from all over the world in almost every language possible in a community. Dennis Walcott, through your leadership as the executive director, and to the entire board, this library has thrived, it has grown, and it has been responsive to the communities under extremely difficult times. I thank you for that on behalf of the people of Queens County. I look forward to this library growing still and helping further generations of children as they grow here in Queens County. With 190 countries and 200 languages, it's not easy to be that responsive, but Queens always does it right, and the public library is no exception. Congratulations on today.
Hey, everybody. This is Hari Kondabolu, and I'm here to wish the Queens Public Library a very happy 125th anniversary. Now, for those of you who are under 18 and for whatever reason are being forced to watch this right now, a library is if the internet was a building. Now, as someone who was born and raised in Queens, I regularly went to branches of our public library system throughout my childhood. In fact, I even interned one summer in high school at the Windsor Park branch and served a very important function. Okay, what I did was put little strips of metal in new books so the metal detector would go off if people tried to steal them. Huh? Yeah. Again, for the younger people, a book is essentially thousands of tweets connected together and printed on paper to tell a story and then bound to make it easier to carry. A book has a couple of major functions. One, to be read in order to access the information within it. And two, to be displayed on shelves as decoration so you look smart on Zoom calls. Now, I long ago sold Queens out and moved to Brooklyn. However, my mother still lives in Queens and is still a devoted member of the Glen Oaks Library. She still regularly goes there despite the fact we haven't lived in that neighborhood in over two decades. And there are at least three other libraries that are closer to the house. But that doesn't matter to her. She's loyal to the Glen Oaks branch because she likes the librarians that work there and the community they've built. That's ultimately what makes Queens Public Library so special. In addition to providing free access to information for all people, it's the communities and cultures of these institutions that make it necessary. And I know in the time of COVID, we all miss community more than ever. So please support Queen's Public Library. We can't afford to lose such a force for truth and democracy in the greatest borough in New York City. And yes, again, I moved to Brooklyn. I am a hypocrite.
Hi, everyone. Jimmy Van Bramer here, council member and chair of the Committee on Cultural Affairs and Libraries in the council. And maybe more importantly for this message, former staffer at the Queens Public Library for 11 years. And I wanted to say to everyone, congratulations, 125 years of Queens Public Library service to the millions and millions of residents of Queens County who have come to rely on our public libraries, not just this year, but every year for the last 125. It's a great honor and privilege to be associated with the greatest public library system in the world and to be a veteran of the Queens Public Library. So congratulations. Thank you all for everything you've ever done on behalf of the Queens Public Library. And thank you to the staff, in particular, the Queens Public Library, 125 years of incredible service to our people. Thank you.
What's up, Queens Library? I'm the Shark Daymond John from ABC Shark Tank. But before I was on ABC Shark Tank, I grew up in Hollis, Queens as a young entrepreneur reaching for the stars. I started a successful clothing brand with my partners named FUBU. The library has always been extremely important to the community and to me myself as well. Libraries are important for young people to get important information. I actually have 5 books that I am happy to share that they are in the Queens Library for the next Daymond John coming up. I love Queens Library for the books, the programs, and the safe place they offer young people. Please support and give to the Queens Library today, and I look forward to meeting the next generation of entrepreneurs from Queens. Thank you to President Dennis Wallcock and my friend Ralph McDaniels for all your amazing work. Stay safe.
Thank you so much, Damon. What a fabulous way to cap off our evening. I'm Michael Rodriguez, Chairman of the Board of Trustees here at the Queensborough Public Library. Today, the need for QPL services is greater than ever. As we rebuild from the pandemic, the library will play a crucial part in the recovery of Queens. We are providing resume help for job seekers, education programming for students that have fallen behind during the pandemic, hotspot circulation for residents without reliable internet, and 24/7 access to online resources. Your donation of any size will make it possible to provide programs for you, your families, and your neighbors. Please make a gift now to help us as we work to build a more vibrant, informed, cohesive, and empowered society. And once again, a special thank you to our top sponsors, Bloomberg Philanthropies and the Margaret and Dan Loeb Foundation, along with support from James S. and Merrill H. Tisch, Citi, the Wolkoff family, and Five Points LIZ, Amazon, and Robert Santos. Thank you all for joining and supporting us this evening. Dennis, I'll hand it back over to you.
Thank you, Michael. And let me thank also our Board of Trustees and our Foundation Board of Directors. And let me thank our guests, our speakers, our sponsors and donors, Awkwafina, Donovan Richards, Min Jin Lee, Corey Johnson, Melinda Katz, Harry Kondabolu, Jimmy Van Bramer, Damon John, and our amazing customers. And to all of our guests, thank you for sharing your evening with us. We are grateful you tuned in tonight. As we celebrate 125 years of the Queens Public Library and our incredible community, it is an honor to serve this institution, and it has been an honor to be with you tonight. Last month, QPL began reintroducing browsing, computer use at our branches, and as we gear up to welcome customers back more fully over the next several months, your support will be critical to our success. This evening, I'm proud to say we have raised over $500,000 to fund our programs, services, and resources. Thank you, thank you, and thank you. But it's not too late still to make a donation using the QR code or the donate button at the end of the program. I am deeply grateful for the continued support from our community and your generous investment in the Queens Public Library. We hope to see you in person at one of our branches soon. Good night, everyone, and thank you.